5G is with us. The technology is here and the applications are lining up to be tried and tested as the world of data intelligence and communication prepares to take another significant step forward as well as up. But what does that revolution involve and how will it change the way we work, study and do business? We're talking to Milan Rao at Wipro, a multinational corporation providing information technology, consulting and business process services. I'm Andrew Wilson. Welcome to the Business Debate. Milan, thanks very much indeed for joining us.
Pleasure being here.
The first question is obviously, what is 5G? More importantly, is the term revolution an overstatement?
Well, 5G is basically the next generation of technologies. You have 2G, 3G, 4G. And this technology is fundamentally more reliable, more scalable, and faster. So from a technological perspective, it's absolutely a revolution. The question is, in terms of usage and adoption, is it going to be a revolution or an evolution? I think there it is a little bit of a question mark.
And this claim that it's going to add billions of dollars, perhaps even inject trillions of dollars into the world economy, is that far-fetched?
No, I think it's absolutely true. GSMA estimates $2.2 trillion being created in the global economy on account of 5G over the next 10 to 12 years. And that is a reality. There are billions of dollars which are being invested in CapEx, $35 to $40 billion by the American majors in 5G technology, about $150 billion by mobile technologists over the course of each year for the next 3 years. That is a lot of money, and there is going to be return on investment on that money.
Well, that's the investment. What's the return going to
be? Well, the return is basically in two ways, as our Wipro looks at it. You know, the first one is, you know, what we call run-up to 5G, which is really getting everything in readiness for 5G. So whether it's semiconductors, devices, network equipment organizations, communication service providers, just get everything ready to 5G, right? The second one is the adoption phase. So the first one is more network and oriented towards network. The second one is adoption in vertical use cases where there are use cases which are across healthcare, across automotive, across gaming, across media, and so on and so forth. And those are the ones which are going to generate the long-term business benefits from 5G.
I mean, as you're president of MIT at Wipro, you're also head of the telecom sector of the company as well. So how quickly do you see this evolution taking place?
So we see, 5G technologies are already in place. There are a lot of trials which are going on. We see a lot of countries and first-line operators launching within the next year or so. But we see the real evolution of the technology happening over the next 3 years. And the business use cases that I'm talking about, which is the real adoption of industrial use cases, that we'll see from the next 2 or 3 years all the way up to the next decade. And that's going to create real value for the customer.
So what does Wipro mean when it talks about a fabric of an entire ecosystem of connected devices?
Yeah, well, just think about billions of devices which are connected. Devices within your home, devices in every single industry, you know, gas turbines, automotive, aircraft, et cetera, et cetera. Estimated more than 20 billion devices right now, increasing to 50 billion by 2020 itself. And all of these devices, if they're connected and people who are connected, 1.4 billion people are going to get added in terms of mobile internet connectivity over the next few years. So imagine all of these people, all of these devices getting connected and what is generated out of that being used for data, being used for communication, being used for industry use cases. That's really what we are talking about, you know, as an ecosystem. And we as a technology services partner, combining with our industry partners, combining with academia and research partners and, you know, new age startup companies. So it's an entire ecosystem which is trying to take this technology further.
So there's an inevitability about it.
I mean, oh, absolutely.
And as this becomes more widespread, what are the priorities that we have to bear in mind as this becomes more and more part of everyday life and business?
I think, you know, the way Wipro looks at it is really three things. You know, the first one is intelligence. There is an incredible amount of intelligence because of all of these people and devices and data getting connected. We have our Wipro Homes platform, which is our homegrown platform. And we're using a lot in Wipro Homes for data analytics, network, prediction, predictability, use cases, and so on and so forth. The second one is 5G offers incredible reliability, which traditional networks did not offer. So that enables you to put out use cases and make sure that they work, right? Put out networks and make sure that the network connectivity is working every time. And that's an incredible support to use cases. And finally, there's security. There's so much of data which is getting generated out of so many different devices. Security is very, very important.
The security must be paramount, I would have thought.
Absolutely. But you know, here's the thing. So you have connectivity with incredible amounts of data being generated. So you need to analyze, you need to have insights, you need to have security, but ultimately you need to have a fabric of reliability. So to my mind, intelligence, reliability, security are all paramount.
So where does Wipro fit into all this? What's Wipro's role in this?
Well, you know, two ways in which we look at it. Like I said, you know, the first one is helping a lot of our partners, whether it's semiconductor companies, devices companies, media companies, communication service providers, and network equipment providers in enabling 5G networks to be rolled out in the first place. So we do everything from infrastructure, application, cloud enablement, digital, to network engineering and use case. The second part is when the use cases actually start being utilized. So imagine in case of healthcare, you know, remote care, patient care, in self-driving autonomous vehicles, in gaming technologies between billions of people. We enable those use cases to come to life. And that's the second part of, you know, what we're looking from a business perspective.
And as a consultancy then, what are your key messages to CXOs looking at the prospects of this new technological future?
Well, I would say, you know, just relook and rethink about what this data can offer to you. You know, A, there is a potential for your entire business model to change because it's going to be mobile first, it's going to be device first, and it's going to be everything on the air everywhere, right? The second part is customer experience fundamentally changes. Imagine people with devices which can virtually do anything, right? So you have edge computing that you will have on the devices, you will have anytime connectivity. What does that do for customer experiences? Customer is going to fundamentally have a different experience, right? And lastly, what does it do for internal collaboration? Because, you know, like we're having this interview, I could be sitting in New York, you could be in London, but it could be a real-time interview.
Milan, thanks very much indeed for joining us.
Yeah, pleasure being here. Thank you.
Do join us again soon for more of the top interviews from the world of international business.